willing to testify. The president insists he still would like to testify before the special counsel Robert Mueller as the two sides negotiate over what topics such an interview could cover. Can his remaining lawyers keep the president from making a risky move? Tanking the Dow. The Dow drops 724 points and other stock indices plunge as President Trump imposes import tariffs on China, sparking fears of a global trade war. Will China strike back at U.S. agriculture and industry? An unjustified killing? Police fire 20 shots at an unarmed man in his grandmother's backyard. There's growing outrage as horrifying new video shows how the encounter unfolded. Was there any justification for the deadly use of force? I'm Wolf Blitzer. You're in the Situation Room.
This is CNN Breaking News.
Breaking news, President Trump insists he still wants to testify before Special Counsel Robert Mueller, even as the lead attorney handling his response to the Russia probe quits, leaving the legal team in disarray. And CNN has learned tonight that at least four prominent lawyers have recently declined offers to join the president's legal team. I'll speak with Senator Chris Coons of the Judiciary and Foreign Relations Committees. And our correspondents and specialists, they are all standing by with full coverage. Let's get to the breaking news. President Trump still wants to meet with Robert Mueller, even as his Russia probe legal team suffers a big shakeup. Let's go to our senior White House correspondent, Jeff Zeleny. Jeff, what's the latest?
Wolf, good evening. The revolving door here at the White House is extending to the president's legal team as well, raising serious issues that he wants to have a more aggressive approach here in the Russia investigation. But all of that, one key question is hanging over this. Will the president testify to the special counsel? I asked the president that directly today in the diplomatic reception room. He looked me square in the eye, and he said yes.
President Trump has spent months blasting the Russia investigation. But tonight, he insists he still wants to sit down and answer questions from Special Counsel Robert Mueller.
Mr. President, would you still like to testify to Special Counsel Robert Mueller, sir?
Thank you.
I would like to.
It's uncertain whether he actually will. The president was not in the mood to take other questions.
Good afternoon.
As he faced another major shakeup on his legal team. John Dowd, the president's lead lawyer on the Russia investigation, resigned today amid disagreements about the direction of Trump's legal strategy. His departure comes 2 days after the president hired longtime conservative Washington attorney Joe DiGenova, who favors a far more aggressive approach to Mueller. It was only 11 days ago when the president wrote this. I am very happy with my lawyers. They are doing a great job and have shown conclusively that there was no collusion with Russia. As the investigation intensifies, CNN has learned the president believes he needs to take the reins of his own legal strategy. Dowd has been more resistant of the president sitting down with Mueller. In a statement to CNN, Dowd said, I love the president and wish him well. Meanwhile, the president slapped major new tariffs today on Chinese imports to the tune of $60 billion a year, punishment for what the U.S. believes are unfair trade practices.
We have a tremendous intellectual property theft situation going on, which likewise is hundreds of billions of dollars.
Tough talk against China was a soundtrack of Trump's bid for the presidency.
We can't continue to allow China to rape our country, and that's what they're doing. It's the greatest theft in the history of the world.
Today, he said he was making good on a campaign promise.
It's probably one of the reasons I was elected, maybe one of the main reasons, but we're not going to let that happen.
The U.S. is bracing for how China will respond, as some business leaders and economists worry that protectionism will spark a trade war. It also comes as the U.S. is hoping Chinese President Xi Jinping will help broker nuclear talks with North Korea.
I have tremendous respect for President Xi. We have a great relationship. They're helping us a lot in North Korea.
All this as the House passed a $1.3 trillion spending bill, a deal to keep the government funded through September. Even though it doesn't include full funding for the president's proposed wall with Mexico,
thanks, Sarah.
White House Budget Director Mick Mulvaney said it has the president's blessing.
Let's cut right to the chase. Is the president going to sign the bill? The answer is yes.
A rather sad chapter in our committee's long history. With the ending of the majority's participation in the investigation, that ending taking place in secret session for no reason at all except a desire to avoid the public scrutiny of this decision to curtail an investigation into one of the most serious intrusions into our democracy in our history.
Let's go to our senior congressional correspondent, Manu Raju. Manu, what are you learning?
Well, Republicans rejected a number of Democratic attempts at this close. Attempt for refusing to answer a number of questions, even though his refusal to answer those questions frustrated a lot of Republicans who themselves had threatened to hold him in contempt. But Republicans instead pushed forward with their own report, their own findings from this investigation that has gone on. For more than a year in their report that they voted today along party lines to declassify, it includes a number of conclusions, including that there was no collusion between the Trump campaign and Russian officials. And they also disputed a key finding in the intelligence community that Vladimir Putin directed a cyber campaign to help President Trump. Now, this is the Republican conclusion that Democrats are furiously rejecting. And I had a chance to talk to the Republican running the Russia investigation, Mike Conaway, about those Democratic demands.
Available across an entire scope of things that we don't believe would be productive in getting to the answers that we needed. We're not running a criminal investigation. We don't have to prove beyond the shadow of a doubt.
And why not hold Bannon in contempt, though?
Well, that wasn't a question for today. That's an open question. And at this point in time, I'm not, I don't think it would be effective. And, we held Eric Holder in contempt. He still doesn't appear to be too hampered by that. And so at this stage of the game, not sure what that would prove.
Do you believe that Clinton was hurt by the Russians, by an active effort by Putin?
Well, I don't think there's any question that she was hurt, wasn't hurt. You know, I don't think there's any question that Putin does not like Ms. Clinton. Whether or not that transferred into him wanting her to not be president or be president, or Trump to be president or not be president, everybody gets to make their mind up on that.
Now, one other point was that firm, the data firm Cambridge Analytica, the one that is the Trump campaign had employed in the 2016 campaign, and the revelations of it working, of getting access to roughly 50 million users on Facebook, their private data, something that Democrats on this committee want to probe. Democrats have gotten some support for some one whistleblower to provide information about exactly what happened here. But when I asked Mike Conaway whether that was of interest to him to reopen open the Russia investigation. He said, Wolf, that it's a, quote, much broader question, quite frankly. He said he does not see how that is tied directly to the question that this investigation was supposed to answer. So another sign that this investigation is done, Wolf. Democrats are trying to pursue something on their own. But they're in the minority, Wolf, and they do not have subpoena power. There's a question about how much information they could ultimately get, Wolf.
Yeah, limited opportunities when you're in the minority. Manu, thanks very much for that. Joining us now, Democratic Senator Chris Coons of Delaware. He's a member of the Judiciary and Foreign Relations Committees. Senator, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Wolf. Always good to be with you.
We have lots to discuss. John Dowd was President Trump's top lawyer. The primary liaison to Robert Mueller's investigative team. With Dowd on the way out, does it look like the president may just fire the special counsel rather than negotiate an interview, for example, with him?
I'm very concerned, Wolf, that that's exactly what may happen in the coming weeks. If you look at the pattern here, the president abruptly Robert Mueller abruptly resigns. I think all of this points, this is not a hint. This is a clear sign that the president is more and more likely to take the unacceptable step of abruptly firing Robert Mueller without cause.
Despite his direct attacks on Robert Mueller over the weekend, the president said today that he still wants to testify before the special counsel. Do you think that's likely?
Well, I hope that the president will continue on a path where he cooperates with the special counsel, does sit down for an interview. But I'll remind you, it was just 10 days ago. Very short periods of time.
Sources tell CNN, Senator, that Mueller's team wants to discuss four main topics with the president: the meeting between the Russians and the Trump campaign officials at Trump Tower in 2016, the president's role in crafting a misleading public statement after that meeting, and the firings of the FBI Director James Comey and the National Security Advisor Michael Flynn. Does it look to you like Mueller is asking the right questions?
Well, those first two would be questions around collusion, and the second two, maybe even the last three, would be around obstruction of justice. I suspect those aren't all the questions he would ask, but those do define some of the core issues that have been examined both in the House and Senate in our Judiciary Committee investigation and from what we know of it publicly, the Intelligence Committee questions. Those do strike me as some of the core issues I would expect Robert Mueller to be looking at.
Meanwhile, Senator, congressional investigators in the House Intelligence Committee are wrapping up their probe, the Republican majority. And as you heard Manu Raju report just a few minutes ago, Republicans on the committee simply say there's nothing left to explore. Your reaction?
I don't think that's accurate. We just had a conversation in the Senate Judiciary Committee earlier today. They've gone to the logical conclusion of their investigation. I am encouraged that the Senate Intelligence Committee continues to make forward progress on a bipartisan basis. In fact, just this week, the Senate Intelligence Committee unanimously made recommendations about how we should be strengthening our state electoral systems in advance of 2018. And in the omnibus that was just voted out by the House, there's $380 million in new grants that would help strengthen our election system. I do think there's positive progress being made by the Senate Intelligence Committee.
Senator Coons, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
President Joe Biden. Biden the other day gave a speech claiming he would have beat the hell out of Trump in high school for bragging about groping women. Now, the president responded on Twitter earlier today. Crazy Joe Biden is trying to act like a tough guy. Actually, he is weak, both mentally and physically, and yet he threatens me for the second time with physical assault. He doesn't know me, but he would go down fast and hard, crying all the way, "Don't threaten people, Joe." go ahead and give me your analysis.
Well, I think that this underscores the way in which the public discourse has changed under this president, where the attacks are a lot more personal in nature. It's not really a debate over policy. This is inevitably going to lead to questions over whether or not Joe Biden is weighing a run in 2020. He certainly has expressed his regret for not running in 2016. And I think that you see maybe perhaps a preview of what a Biden-Trump face-off might look like. Whether or not he's the right answer to Democrats' problems, that's a separate question.
You think it's a preview to 2020?
I hope not. Honestly, it's ridiculous. Come on, guys. It's, two septuagenarians sounding like kids in a schoolyard, these guys. Get over that already. And it doesn't help Biden, just like it didn't help Marco Rubio during the primaries, to get down to that level. And just stop it, guys.
Let me get Deanna to weigh in. Go ahead, Deanna.
Yeah, well, it certainly doesn't meet the Michelle Obama smell test of,
exactly.
When they go low, we go high. But
right.
At the same time, Joe Biden has been known to speak his mind. That's how he's been in the past. He's had his gaffes. And I remember people even speculating if there was one person who could take the president on, given it.